In this video lecture, we are going to discuss multiple choice question and its answers from the topic steam boilers. Question number 121. The diameter of fire tube of Cornish boiler compared to its shell is option A 1/2, option B 1/3, option C 2/5, option D 3/5. Answer option D 3/5. Question number 122. The length of Cornish boiler is of the order of option A 2 to 4 meters, option B 3 to 5 meters, option C 5 to 7.5 meters, option D 7 to 9 meters. Answer option C 5 to 7.5 meters. Question number 123. Cochrane boiler is a option A horizontal fire tube boiler, option B horizontal water tube boiler, option C vertical water tube type, option D vertical fire tube type. Answer option D vertical fire tube type. Question number 124. Locomotive boiler has option A 137 fire tubes and 44 superheated tubes, option B 147 fire tubes and 34 superheated tubes, option C 157 fire tubes and 24 superheated tubes, option D 167 fire tubes and 14 superheated tubes. Answer option C 157 fire tubes and 24 superheated tubes. Question number 125. Water tube boilers produces steam at a dash pressure than that of fire tube boilers. Option A higher, option B lower, option C same, option D none of the above. Answer option A higher. Question number 126. Lawman boiler is a dash pressure water tube steam boiler working on forced circulation. Option A low, option B high, option C equal, option D all of the above. Answer option B high. Question number 127. Which of the following is best suited to meet fluctuating demand of steam? Option A locomotive boiler, option B Lancashire boiler, option C Cornish boiler, option D Babcock boiler and Wilcox boiler. Answer option A locomotive boiler. Question number 128. Cochrane boiler is a option A horizontal fire tube boiler, option B horizontal water tube boiler, option C vertical water tube type, option D vertical fire tube type. Answer option D vertical fire tube type. Question number 129. The biggest loss in the boiler is option A moisture in fuel, option B dry in flue gases, option C steam formation, option D unburned carbon. Answer option B dry in flue gases. Question number 130. The ratio of heat actually used in producing the steam to the heat liberated in the furnace is called option A steam efficiency, option B boiler efficiency, option C evaporation capacity of a boiler, option D none of the above. Answer option B boiler efficiency. Question number 131. The draught in locomotive boilers is produced by A option A chimney, option B centrifugal fan, option C steam jet, option D all of the above. Answer option C steam jet. Question number 132. The draught may be produced by a option A chimney, option B mechanical fan, option C steam jet, option D all of the above. Answer option D all of the above. Question number 133. The mechanical draught produces dash draught than natural draught. Option A more, option B less, option C equal, option D none of the above. Answer option A more. Question number 134. The efficiency of the plant dash with the mechanical draught. Option A increases, option B decreases, option C remain constant, option D none of the above. Answer option A increases. Question number 135. The mechanical draught dash the amount of smoke. Option A increases, option B decreases, option C does not affect, option D remain same. Answer option B decreases. Question number 136. The chimney draught varies with option A climatic condition, option B temperature of furnace gases, option C height of chimney, option D all of the above. Answer option D all of the above. Question number 137. The draught produced by a steam jet issuing from a nozzle placed in the chimney is called option A induced steam jet draught, option B forced steam jet draught, option C chimney draught, option D none of the above. Answer option A induced steam jet draught. Question number 138. The air pressure at the fuel bed is reduced below that of atmosphere by means of a fan placed at or near the bottom of the chimney to produce a draught. Such a draught is called option A natural draught, option B induced draught, option C forced draught, option D balanced draught. Answer option B induced draught. Question number 139. Locomotive boiler is of the following type. Option A multitubular, option B horizontal, option C internally fired, option D all of the above. Answer option D all of the above. Question number 140. The actual vacuum in a condenser is equal to option A barometric pressure plus actual pressure, option B barometric pressure minus actual pressure, option C gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure, option D gauge pressure minus atmospheric pressure. Answer option B barometric pressure minus actual pressure. Thank you.